Euro Cups.
With active driving, active safety, Subaru.
Rangers received an early shock when Sergio Perini scored in his own net in the 7th minute to put the Irish part-timers 1-0 ahead. Mark Rutherford made it 2-0 just 3 minutes before half-time. Delight for the 600 Shelburne fans who made the trip to Tranmere. And then Pat Morley added a third in the 58th minute, a classic goal on the break. Then just 2 minutes later, the fortunes of both sides was to change. Shelburne's Tony McCarthy handled in the box. George Albert slotted home Rangers first from the penalty spot. Then it was time for two of Rangers' new signings to make an impact. Half-time substitute Gabriel Amato scored in 71 minutes. The Rangers fans no doubt hoping they've signed a striker worthy of replacing Negri. Then new Dutch signing Giovanni van Bronckhorst tied the scores with a drive in the 73rd minute. But then it was Amato back in the score sheet again, the goal which gave Rangers the lead arriving 8 minutes from time.
And finally Albert rounded off the scoring with his second penalty. Delight for Rangers, and don't bet against another five at Ibrox next Wednesday.
Just 3 minutes later, Andre Kanchelskis, also in his home debut, that cut back to Johansson, and it's 1-0 Rangers. Good build-up by the Russian, and the first goal of the season for Johansson. Rangers, though, proved just too strong for the visitors from Ireland, and from this deflection, it was Jonathan Johansson who added a second, proving to Dick Advocaat that he's got a place in the Rangers side in the future. A good warm-up by Rangers for their game against Hearts on Sunday. And in the end, 7-3 on aggregate.
Good evening, well.
Newman pushing forward more, as you can see now. Van Bronckhorst. Well, it's a little bit slow. He turns well and that person chipped the ball across.
Poor header from Kanchelskis. Alberts was up in support, but he couldn't work the ball through. And now Olivares trying to use his pace against Craig Moore. And that's a good ball in, saved by Charbonnier. What a good stop that was from Cominguez, just as it looked as if Pauk would take the lead. Again, it was Olivares. A great cutback, and that was instinctive goalkeeping from Charbonnier.
Left in him. I think that, you know, the free kick, although it was well struck, was well off target, the last opportunity for him to do anything in the game.
Franciscos, shot off the bar by Cafes. It was Franciscos who set him up, and that swerving effort, Charbonnier could only look at it as it cannon back. It looked like the connection of bar and post, and that could so easily have brought Pauk back into this tie.
Yeah, I'm not sure whether that took a lot of deflection or not.
had come out of possession. Roybal. And there it is, no, and down comes a goalkeeper. There's going to be an appeal for a penalty kick, and it's been given. The referee, the French referee, and Lionel Charbonnier disgusted with his colleague there. It was a very late challenge there by Charbonnier, but Bernard Sow, the French referee, for this challenge here. Look at Amoroso, he doesn't clear it properly. Out comes Charbonnier. And I think he embellished that fall. Let's have a look at it again. The goalkeeper goes down and there is a contact just towards the end there, and it's a penalty kick. Exactly 16 minutes gone. Well, there had been a little warning earlier on. Here he goes, and it's in. Scored by Yossi Abouksis. Beitar Jerusalem, a one-up. As I said, 16 minutes gone, and there is a very depressed Frenchman indeed. First, Densaz going across, and Albert, beautiful play by Albert. Here's a counter-attack. It's played deep and long, and Kanchelskis pops up here. Going inside, can he put it across? Albert with the shot! Oh, what a brilliant goal! That left foot, that classic, majestic, hammering left foot of his, is a vital, crucial, perhaps even luxurious goal, because I think Rangers have shown enough in getting a goal away from home to go through to the next leg. Early ones yet, but look at this. Kanchelskis, who really has been the thorn in the flesh in the second half, laying it out to the big German, who brilliantly kept it down. A difficult ball to take through a cluster of players, kept his head down, and that vulnerable goalkeeper is left stranded. One each. Well, we did say in the first half that Rangers had the ability to break down this defence. They were desperately unlucky in not doing so a couple of times in the second half before that hammer strike. Here's Van Bronckhorst, and the whistle is gone. I think...
Italy or Spain's Atletico Madrid after an impressive 4-2 win over Vitor of Jerusalem at Ibrox on Thursday night. Rino Gattuso gave the home side an overall lead in the tie in the first minute. Sergio Perini added a second in 25 minutes, and it all looked done and dusted until István Szolai sneaked one back for Beitar. A half-time pep talk, however, from Dick Advocaat must have done the trick. Johansson made it 3-1 on the hour. Rod Wallace added the fourth 5 minutes later, despite the clear penalty claims before he dispatched the ball into the net. And although Ohana scored from the penalty spot 10 minutes from time, Rangers were comfortably through 4-2 on the night, 5-3 over the two legs.
Roberto dazwischen. Van Bronckhorst, da ist es! Man schreibt dann die 45. Eigentlich war es die 46. Jetzt haben sie völlig geschlafen, hier Sekunden vor der Pause, wohl mit den Gedanken schon in der Kabine. Und er macht das Tor, Giovanni van Bronckhorst, der Niederländer. War mit bei der WM, hat da kein Spiel gemacht. Und hier steht er völlig frei. Kein Abseits, gar kein Thema. Und jetzt wird es ganz schwer für Bayer Leverkusen. 0-1, die Rangers führen in Leverkusen. Auf deutschem Boden geschossen haben. Vorher in 4 Spielen, zweimal gegen Köln, einmal gegen Gladbach und einmal gegen Dortmund. Ist ihnen Kovac jetzt als letzter Mann gegen Wallace. Novotny jetzt endgültig vor der Abwehr. Und das kann dann passieren. Hinten sind sie offen. Wallace. Links Johansson. Welcher Stürmer da in der EM-Qualifikation auf die Deutschen zukommt? Jonathan Johansson. Alles völlig offen bei Leverkusen. Katastrophal. Novotny weit vor der Abwehr, Happe mit aufgerückt. Und dann stand im Grunde Robert Kovac, Mutterseelen allein. Gegen Wallace, der das prima macht. Und gegen ihn, gegen Jonathan Johansson. Nur haben wir den Salat. Dick Advokat. Die Anzeige da noch 4 Minuten, dann ist jetzt noch rund eine. Niko Kovac. Spiel läuft weiter. Novotny. Ja, Grebsch. C. Roberto bewegt sich gar nicht mehr. Der steht fast. Und da ist er drin! Ich sag's doch, Herr Reichenberger! Prima reagiert!
Kein Stollengeklacker da unten, wohl gedämpft über einen Teppich geht's. Nette Geste der Schotten, dass sie unsere Kamera da reingelassen haben. Service für sie zu Hause. Und jetzt kommen sie raus. Ramelow. Immer noch Ramelow. Und jetzt aufpassen. 3 gegen 1. Johansson. Der Mann, der im Hinspiel das 2:0 gemacht hat, sorgt hier möglicherweise für die Entscheidung. Jonathan Johansson, als alle mit einem Abspiel rechnen. Ein wunderbar gezirkelter Ball, 18 Meter in den Winkel. Das ist mehr als die kalte Dusche, das ist möglicherweise das Aus. Ist es soweit, die Glasgow Rangers und Bayer Leverkusen trennen sich 1:1. Eine starke Leistung von Bayer, aber ein ernüchterndes Resultat, denn das 1.
This is my church. This is where I heal my hurt.
5 minutes into the second half. 0-0. There's Benavivo. Head on. And here's Crespo. Chance for Parma. Saved by Niemi, but Balbo scores on the rebound. Rangers have started the second half so well. And it's the sucker punch from Parma. Crespo found a way through, saved by Niemi, but Balbo tucked away the rebound.
Yeah, that was a danger. Fantastic run with Crespo. He got away from Amoruso. He was left. Niemi did brilliantly just to save it there. But nobody tracked Balbo as he followed up that twin strike force. Look at this ball through there. Just cut right through the Rangers defence. Good save. Just unfortunate Balbo's followed up before any other Rangers defender can. Almost got there. He just tried to do same as Larsson did at the weekend. Learned his lesson, Niemi, with that one, but he's no luck there at all. No help, in fact, as well.
Ian Ferguson's cushion header for Albert. Now Barry Ferguson. Colin Hendry's won it. Rob Wallace! Rob Wallace equalises for Rangers! 22 minutes of the second half gone! And Rangers back on level terms! Hendry played a big part in this, and it's his 14th goal of the season for Rob Wallace!
Yeah, Hendry's made a full recovery certainly from that chance on the post. What a good header it was. He got up at the back post, you look at his power. Strength and Wallace totally alone. Defender's not picking him up. Excellent from Rangers' point of view. Substitute will be made now. Perron is coming off. That's good news for Rangers. But look at a good ball from Barry Ferguson. Great work from Hendry. Wallace, a lot of composure. He had to bring it down, take his touch. Before Turan can meet the challenge, he slotted away in the corner. Puts Rangers back level 10. I said you need to get a goal back soon.
Very cool play from Lorenzo Amoruso. Now Newman. Rangers know there's not too much longer to go in this match. Amato, Sartor at his back, good skill from Amato. Back for Juni! What a miss, Scott Juni. He doesn't need us to tell him. That was the chance. 3 minutes into stoppage time for Rangers to win the game.
Harry County, brilliant skills in the wing by Amato. Chipped it right onto Gordon Juni. Said, if MD expect to score, look at the Italian defenders. They expect that ball. He just landed in the net. Look at that bit of skill there. But Gordon Juni normally would put these away. That's going to be considered a very, very bad miss. He's up above the ball as well. Not...
Here comes Turam for Parma. This side never to be discounted. Turam's continued his run into the box. And a save by Niemi. Absolutely superb. That was a real chance for Parma to win the match. And spectacular goalkeeping from the Finnish international.
It was a time for him to deflect that there. Benaribo had made a great run forward. Barry Ferguson tracked his run.
28 minutes gone. It's 0-0 in Parma. And that's given away by Cincini to George Albert. What a chance this is for George Albert. Albert scores for Rangers. 28 minutes gone. Terrible mistake by Cincini, and Parma are punished by Albert, his 13th goal of the season. And the Rangers supporters inside the Ennio Tardini Stadium are into major celebration.
Well, it was a bad mistake by Cincini, but there was still a lot to do from Albert. He had to control it, he had to show pace. He had to get himself in a shooting position and then he had to fire it in. What a fantastic strike that was. Really has opened up the game. That's the away goal Rangers needed. Puts them now in front in the tie, not even gets them in level terms. Fantastic work by Albert. Did it all on his own there. A little bit of a solo, but what a good strike it was when he was in there. A lot to do, as I said, and he finished it with real aplomb.
In from Veron, but it was too close to Antti Niemi. It was ahead of Balbo and Chiesa. As we look again at the celebrations of George Albert, has he ever scored a more...
Here's Gordon Juri, thinking about a shot from way out, knocked away by Cincini. This first half is almost over. Colin Hendry watchful under that long ball forward. Veron away from Perini, and Sergio Perini will be sent off here.
It's a second yellow card and high drama right at the end of the first half. A late challenge on Veron, a second booking for Perini, and Rangers are down to 10 men. This was the challenge. He was off balance. Veron was away from him. Took a couple of paces before he stumbled to the ground, Veron. It's a free kick to Parma, and Sergio Perini sensationally sent off.
I think Veron knew what he was doing. I don't think that he was...
At the moment, Thuram, with Van Bronckhorst in front of him, through for Balbo. Now it's Veron. Trying to get in behind Van Bronckhorst. It's beyond Niemi, headed back across. And it's Balbo, that's the equaliser. Balbo, who scored at Ibrox, levelled the tie in Parma, less than 2 minutes of the second half gone. Rangers' defence always looked in trouble against the cross from Veron and bundled over the line by Balbo.
Well, I think it's quite astonishing because there's a situation right away, the ball's knocked to the back post, that's your right back area, you would normally have a defender there, Colin Henry's having to stretch for it, not back across goal.
Dino Baggio heading for the penalty box to support Abel Balbo. Fuser just at the edge, Sensini, Cannavaro is up as well. And Juan Veron, a menacing figure just outside the box, in from Chiesa, Albert's header. Shooting opportunity for Fiore, and Fiore scores for Parma. 18 minutes into the second half, he'd all the time he wanted there to firstly control the ball, and then lash the right foot shot where Antti Niemi couldn't get to it. And the match now slipping away from Rangers, Parma 2-1 up.
Marvellous strike, you have to say. Looked like a decent header at first for Malberts, but there was nobody there, and he vexed the first man to go to it. Turns his back on it, though, as a shot.
Fuser to Fiore. Cannavaro and Veron. The pass for Chiesa. A handball used by Lorenzo Amoruso. He was beaten by the bounce. He used his hand to punch away the ball from Chiesa. It's a penalty kick with 22 and a half minutes of the second half gone. A moment of misery here for Rangers captain Lorenzo Amoruso. He'd misjudged it. It was dropping for Chiesa. But surely the hand was rash.
Moment of stupidity, in my opinion. I mean, the score at 2-1 to do that. I mean, he's chasing the ball. Chiesa isn't in a scoring chance, he should really have just left it.
Here's Chiesa.
And that must surely be the moment this UEFA Cup tie is lost for Rangers. There was a way back for them, but it seems not now. Niemi beaten. An act of folly from Lorenzo Amoruso. He handled the ball. Penalty kick tucked away by Chiesa. 3-1 Parma.
Yeah, any hope?